Hello children, hope you are all enjoying all the stories. So in that line, today we are going to see a new story. The story name is Ritu's Letter Gets Longer. The story has been written by Mala Kumar and illustrations are given by Kenu. And the publisher is Pratham Books. So this story tells about Ritu's letter. This girl is Ritu. Okay? Grandpa was writing a letter. Ritu stood beside him, leaning on the arm of the old chair. Grandpa, have you asked Auntie to send money to our home for the holidays? This standing position is called lean, means not standing straight, but also she takes a support. She rests on the arm, and this position is called leaning. Okay. Ritu sees Grandpa writing a letter. She comes and stands next to him, and she asks that whether he has asked Auntie to send money for the holidays. Of course, dear Ritu, I have written to your auntie. Look here. Let me read out the letter. Dear Pooja, hope you are fine. Money must be having holidays now. Ritu is very eager to see him. Do send him here to Tumkur. Tumkur is a place in Karnataka state. So now, grandfather replies to Ritu. He says, yes, of course. I have written to your auntie to send money to our place for vacation. And he also adds, let me read the letter. Grandfather says that Ritu is also very excited to meet money. Ritu jumped up and down. And since she could not stop herself, she ran around the room once and hugged Grandpa. Would you like to post this letter yourself? Asked Grandpa. Ritu's eyes opened wide. All by myself? Oh, may I? Ritu is so happy after hearing about the letter. She could not resist her happiness. She jumps up and down. She goes around the room once and comes and hugs her grandfather once. Grandfather also asks Ritu whether she would like to post the letter by herself. Once again, Ritu could not control her joy. She expressed her joy by opening her eyes widely. See how I'm opening? She opens her eyes very widely and says, oh, can I do that? Yes, little Ritu. See, I have written the address. Take it to the post office. Give the postcard to Ramesh uncle. You do know that big uncle with the big handlebar mustaches, don't you? Yes, Grandpa. He is the uncle who taught money how to ride the cycle last summer. Will he take the letter to Auntie Pooja? Asked Ritu. No, dear. But the letter will reach your auntie. Don't worry. Grandfather again confirms that Ritu can take the letter to the post office and post it by herself. And he adds that he has written the address also. He says that there will be an uncle called Ramesh who will be having a big handlebar like mustaches. Hearing that, Ritu recollects and says that he was the one who taught money how to ride the bicycle during last vacation. Ritu picked up her little pink bag. She put the postcard inside. She put a pencil inside too. She felt very important. Ritu felt very grown up and just a wee bit scared. What if Bagheera, the dog, chased her? But Ritu was very eager to post the letter. So she left for the post office that was just 4 buildings away. Ritu gets ready by taking her little pink bag, and without fail, she takes a pencil also with her. She thinks that it was so important for her to take a pencil. And now Ritu feels that she was so responsible by doing all these things, but a very little bit scared also because of Bagheera, the dog, might chase her. Ritu was so thrilled to post the letter, and the post office was 4 buildings away from their building where they were living. After taking a few steps, Ritu stopped and took out the letter. She could not read Grandpa's handwriting very well. She tried to remember what Grandpa had read. Then, after the word that she thought was Tumkur, Ritu wrote, "Please." Happy with her work, Ritu walked on. After taking 1 or 2 steps, Ritu stopped, took out the letter, and started writing something next to the word Tumkur. The word she wrote was please. She was so happy that she has added this word and started walking. After she had reached the next building, Ritu stopped and took out the postcard once again. What if Pooja aunty did not realize how eager Ritu was to see money? So Ritu took out her pencil again and wrote, "Please." Again, after reaching the next building, Ritu stopped and took out the postcard. She was thinking that her aunt might not realize how much she longed for money to visit her. So she again started adding something to the letter, and the word was again, please. Finally, Ritu reached the small post office. There was a red post box outside the post office. Ritu could not reach the mouth of the post box, even if she stood on her toes. The position Ritu is standing is called standing on the toes. So at last, Ritu reached the post office. Even after trying to increase her height by standing on the toes, Ritu could not reach the post box mouth. And she's not able to post the letter. See how she's standing and trying to insert the letter inside, but it is not happening. She walked boldly up to Uncle Ramesh. He took the postcard from her and smiled. "Smart girl. Now run back to your house carefully. I shall make sure your letter reaches your auntie." But Ritu did not run out. She saw Uncle Ramesh pick up a pen and scribble something on the card. Then he gave it to the postman, who was stamping many letters with a postmark. Since Ritu could not drop the letter inside the box, she picked up courage and approached Uncle Ramesh. This uncle is Ramesh uncle. She handed over the postcard to this uncle. After getting the card, Ramesh uncle asked Ritu to go back home, and he assured that the letter will reach her auntie. But Ritu did not go home. She saw Ramesh uncle writing something on the card and handing it over to the postman who was stamping the letters. Dham, dham, dham. He pounded on the letters. When he saw Ritu's letter, he stopped. Then he smiled. He picked out a pencil from behind his ear and wrote something on the card. So he was stamping the letter with the sound dham, dham. When he saw Ritu's letter, he stopped stamping, and with a smile, he started writing something on the letter with his pencil, which was taken from his ear back. 5 days passed. The postman brought a letter to Grandpa. Grandpa read it with a smile. Ritu, your auntie says she will send money here day after. Let me read out the letter. Dear father, tara ra ra da, ta da 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 da. I am sending money tomorrow. He will reach Tumkur on Friday. I think Ritu must be very eager to see him. Your letter was very interesting. After 5 days, they received a reply from Auntie Pooja. Grandpa read the letter with a smile and started to read out the letter to Ritu. In the letter, Auntie has mentioned that she is sending money and he will be reaching Tumkur on Friday. She had also written that the letter was interesting. Grandpa, I wrote please on the letter. That's why, said Ritu in excitement. Your postcard had 20 pleases written all over it. Ritu was so happy and she said, Grandpa, only because of me writing please, Auntie is going to send money. Grandpa continued to read the letter by saying, there were 20 pleases written all over the card. See, one here, one there, one here, one here, one here, like that. 20 pleases were written on the letter. Ritu did not know how one please had become 20. She was just happy. She had added one please and another please. Ritu cannot understand the secret behind one please becoming 20 pleases. Please, 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 please. Now we come to know the secret, right? How one please became 20 pleases. All these persons have added one word to the letter, and that word was please. Yes, did you all like? Bye-bye. Difficult words. Pound, to strike repeatedly with great force with an instrument. Eager, full of desire or interest. Scribble, to write hastily or carelessly. Try this. Write a convincing letter to your relative to send your cousin to your place for vacation. Next one. How will you express your excitement when you hear that the most awaited cousin has agreed to come?